गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ साईनाथ लंबाडे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू अबाउट द न्यूरॉन्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द जनरलाइज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ न्यूरॉन. हैज ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट न्यूरॉन इज very important cell in carrying out the communication in the complex structure of human body. Neuron is covered by neurilemma. Neuron cell is covered by the neurilemma, and this neurilemma has been divided into two types. That first one is the cyton, and second one, that is a cytoplasmic extension. Cyton means, you may say, that cell body of a neuron, and or you may say it as a soma. And cytoplasmic extension again has been divided into two types, that is a dendron and axon. That is a dendron and axon. These are the two extensions of the neuron cells. Dendrons are the smaller extensions which are seen in the surface or at the periphery of the cyton. At the periphery of the cyton, and that carries the impulse towards the cell body. That is called as a dendron, and these axons carry the impulse away from the cell body. Neuron cell se bahar leke jata hai jo impulse, that is a axon that carries away impulse from the cell body, and it is a bigger as compared to the dendron. Again, next slide we'll see that about the cyton. This cyton, cell body or soma, this, what does the neuron cyton contains? What is present in the body of that particular cyton? That contains a granular cytoplasm. The neurons contains a granular cytoplasm. Granules are the conical. How are these granules? These granules are conical and rich in RNA. They are rich in RNA, and they help in the protein synthesis. They also help in the RNA, help in the protein synthesis. So they are also called as a Nissl's granules. And these Nissl's granules also do the secretion of neurotransmitter. That is acetylcholine or adrenaline. That is secreted by the Nissl's granule. So this Nissl's granule produce a enzyme and neurotransmitter called as acetylcholine and adrenaline. The point is to be clear to you. Also having the presence of network of neurofibrils. In this cytoplasm of neuron, there is also having the presence of network of neurofibrils. Means neurofibers are present and they help in the communication. Various cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi complex, RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum, and centrally placed nucleus. Then again, we'll see that two types of cytoplasmic extensions are present. These two types of cytoplasmic extensions actually are the dendron, or these dendrons are also called as dendrites. And another extension, that is axon. Dendrites are thin, small cytoplasmic extension seen in the periphery of the cyton and cell body. This neuron which carry impulse towards the cell body, they are provided with neurofibrils. They are having the presence of neurofibrils. So this neurofibrils also help in the transmissions of the impulse. So this impulse is carried out towards the cell body. Again, we are going to see this axon. Axon is the longest cytoplasmic process. This axon is the longest cytoplasmic process useful in the conduction of impulse away from the cell body and lined by the axonal membrane. This axon is lined by the axonal membrane and cytoplasm is called as a exoplasm. The cytoplasm of this axon is called as a exoplasm, and exoplasm is continuation with the cytoplasm of cyton. This exoplasm is a continuation which is the cytoplasm which is mainly present in the cyton, neuron's body. That part is called as a neuroplasm. We may say that as a neuroplasm. But if that cytoplasm is mainly present in the axon, so it may be also called as a exoplasm. That is also may be called as a exoplasm. And it contains large number of mitochondria plus rough endoplasmic reticulum and neurofibrils, but lacks nisus granules and Golgi complex. This here one question arises or may carry the one question arise like this. Either there is a presence of nisus granules or Golgi complex in the cytoplasm of axon. You should confirmly say that there is an absence of nisus granules and Golgi complex in the exoplasm. So shall I start with this next slide? That one is the last one about the neurons. As axon throughout the length, is wrapped by the Schwann cells. As axons are covered by the Schwann cells, and these which forms a insulating, these Schwann cells secretes the insulating material and forms a myelinated sheath. And this myelinated sheath is made up of lipids. And such neurons are called as a myelinated neurons. Those neurons are having the presence of myelinated sheath. They are called as a myelinated neuron. Point to be clear here. Some animals' neuron lack myelin sheath. And thus have non-myelinated neurons. So they are called as a non-myelinated neurons. These non-myelinated neurons are also having the presence of Schwann cells, but they are not secreting these insulating or this fiber, this myelin fiber. They are not there secreting in the non-myelinated neurons. Neuron presence of many swollen knob-like structure called as a telodendrons. These telodendrons are present at the last end of the these axons. These are the end points of the axons and are filled with neurosecretory. These telodendrons are filled with a neurosecretory acetylcholine and adrenaline. Both acts as a neurotransmitter. Depending on the number of arrangement of cytoplasmic extension. Now we are going to see this neuron and we are going to study that depending on the arrangement of cytoplasmic extensions, this neurons has been divided again into three types, that is a unipolar, bipolar and multipolar. In unipolar, it has a single process. in unipolar, means single process, and that is also called as a monopolar neurons. That is also called as a monopolar neurons. And in bipolar, there are having the two processes. In bipolar, there are coming the two extensions, and these originate from opposite poles. They are exactly opposite poles of the cell body. So this type of is called as a bipolar neurons. And again, last one, that is a multipolar, have more than two processes. These are having the more than two processes, that is called as a multipolar neuron. And depending on the function of the neurons, again, this neurons has been divided into three types. Depending on the function of the neurons, first neuron, that is a sensory neuron, second one, that is an intermediate neuron, and third one, that is a motor neuron, that is a motor neuron. These sensory neurons respond to the external stimulus. This responds to the external stimulus and carries impulse towards the CNS, central nervous system. And intermediate neurons, actually, this axonal part of sensory neuron terminate in the intermediate neuron and neurons in the brain and the spinal cord. These intermediate neurons, the ending points are converted into the intermediate point. Axonal ends points are continued as a intermediate, mainly present in the brain and the spinal cord. And last one, that is a last one, motor neuron. Motor neuron carry the impulse from the CNS towards the effector organs, that might be muscles and gonads. Thank you everyone for this lecture.